Come on, wave, wave, one of you wave, somebody wave. There we go. Oh, awesome. They're all waving. Hi, guys, and welcome to another video. Yeah, we're waving at the start of the video this time. Once again, we're not a loading screen. That's a nice little shot of Kraukatorik or whatever you want to call him there. Because I decided once again, since we're going to Sacnoth Valley, we don't have to see the walk there. So I've made the same walk, but I've started filming a little bit early because we're actually going to be walking across this beach. Yes, you can actually walk across the beach, and there is stuff over here. We've been here in quite a few episodes, and every single time we've come here, I thought, oh, I kind of want to show you everyone what's over here. So instead of walking to Sacnoth Valley through that way, I've decided to come through this way. So it takes you to the same explorable area. There's nothing really amazing here. There's this waterfall, I guess, but aside from that, there's nothing really that cool here. You can come through. Actually, I've talked about it a little bit before in the Let's Play with these portals and how you can like hop behind the portals. I particularly remember talking about that in the Domain of Anguish, actually, and one of the areas I wanted to hop behind. And somebody actually sent in a video response. And if you're still there watching, thank you very much for that. That was so awesome. And this guy had showed me how he actually did it. He did like a crazy thing using a pet that I still don't fully understand, but he'd got behind. Anyway, my point is, you can actually, if you look at the portals here, there's actually a huge distance there. There's a whole path there that we can't really walk on. If you portal hop behind here, and indeed I have done this before, you can actually sort of map out an extra part of the world map, which is pretty cool. And just see, I think it's generally just kind of crap stuff over there. There's nothing really that amazing. But yeah, it's kind of cool anyway. Anyway, so yeah, this is Sacnoth Valley again. A little section of Sacnoth Valley, shall we say, that we haven't seen before. Another refugee. These guys all say the same stuff, don't they? It kind of sucks. In all the other areas, they have unique things to say to us. But no, not here. The bounty givers are all boring. Which is a shame, because, you know, the humans here. And oh, this place looks pretty awesome. This reminds me of, and I don't know why, I guess it's because of the little sparkles, the moon flow from Final Fantasy X, if you guys know what I'm talking about there. It's always reminded me of the moon flow. Anyway, right, so here's Vale. Oh, wow, really? Does he just spawn whatever portal we go through? Actually, I think he does spawn it. Oh, wow, that was pretty good luck then. All right, so here he is. This is the sort of the back entrance to the stronghold here. You can see that it's closed here. And we're actually going to sneak in with Vale. And I'm going to listen to Wiki again, which is generally, this is not how I usually play this quest. But I think Wiki makes out that you can do it without your heroes. So, hell yes, I'm all up for that, since, you know, we did solo prophecies, because I don't like how the heroes and henchmen always bug up the screen and everything becomes a huge clusterfuck. So if we've actually got a quest that we can do solo, I will definitely be doing it. Anyway, hi Vale.
I'm afraid I'm busy.
Yes, you've been watching us for a long time. Forbidden Fruit. I see you're getting the hang of covert work. I've recently procured a potion of considerably slumberous nature from an Assyrian alchemist and created a couple of bombs to set off within yon stronghold. Here's the deal. Once the char inside are safely dozing, you'll have little time to get in, find their stores of food, poison the stores with this, and get out. Fun! Time is of the essence once the bombs hit. Just in and out. Don't dawdle. So, I am ready. Let's do it. Is the thing going to open? Yeah, there we go. That's actually quite funny. Those rocks kind of slide to the side to let us in. Yeah, I'm going to leave the guys back there. It's just me and Vale from here on out. No compass. Hopefully it will knock out the char. We probably won't see because of the compass, but... Alright, the gas will take effect momentarily. I'm going in, says Vale. Oh, he just disappeared. He just shadow stepped. Okay, cool. Right, so we got some char there. There we go. Did you see him to get knocked out? Don't worry, we'll be gone long before the convulsions and vomiting start. Time remaining, 3 minutes. So actually, the end of the last video, I said that this quest wasn't that interesting and they will sound a lot cooler than they actually are. I take it back. I completely forgot what this quest was like. I take it back. This is awesome. All right, so where are we going? We're going to the top. We've got to poison their food stores. Also, while we're here, we should have time. But I've got something quite important to talk about, namely about what we are stood on right now. Hold on. Oh god, that was not a good time for me to be interrupted. Alright, let's keep going. Alright, so over here we got the food supplies. Run, 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 run. Actually, I've got Enraging Charge. I should probably use that. How many food supplies are there? So we got one. Alright, quest updated. We got another one. Quest updated again. Where are we going to now? Oh, all the way down. Alright, so on our walk there, I will talk about this thing. Here, this thing here, you guys might recognise it. You probably don't because I never went there in pre-searing because we kind of skipped a hell of a lot of stuff in pre-searing. But this thing here is the Cauldron of Cataclysm. This is the thing that the Char used to bring down the Searing. This is the thing that I talked about that's been described lately as being fused with magic. Oh god, I forgot about my vampiric weapon. Being fused with, and shit, my hotkeys aren't set up, so I'm going to have to unequip that. Oh god, this is not going good. I hope I don't run out of time. Ah, I haven't emptied my inventory. Oh, it's all coming back to bite me in the arse. Alright, anyway, yeah. That's the thing that the Char used. It's said to be fused with ancient magics from things that have since fallen to sleep, namely the Elder Dragons. That's what they used to bring down the Searing. And in the mission, in this stronghold here, you actually see Hierophant Burnt Soul stood by it, which is really interesting, not just because it's here and they've kind of referenced it again and said, hey, yeah, this thing does exist. I think we need to leave now, do we? Yeah, report back to Vale. It's not just interesting that this thing exists, that it's here, but it's also kind of interesting that Hierophant Burnt Soul's the guy that we see next to it. Okay, and as we know, the Char Warband, the way that they work to denote what Warband a Char is in, the first part of a Char's second name is the Warband. So, Pyre Fierce Shot is in the Fierce Warband, and all of his friends had Fierce. They were Fierce, whatever, Quick Fierce, Fierce Soul or whatever. Was Fierce Soul one of them? I can't remember. Anyway, Hierophant Burnt Soul has the same name as someone called... Oh, crap, I forget his name. It's like Burnt Char, Burnt Ember or something. Basically, one of the bosses that was stood in Pre-Searing, if we'd gone to the Cauldron of Cataclysm in Pre-Searing, we would have seen a Char Elementalist, and I will edit the name in on the video right now for you. And he seems to be in the same warband as Hierophant Burnt Soul. So it's kind of like there's this warband of the Flame Legion who really... who are in charge of the Cauldron of Cataclysm, almost. It's kind of odd like that, isn't it? It's pretty cool, though, and it's nice to see it there, and I regret not mentioning it when we could have first seen it during the mission and he was there, but there you go. I knew we would have a chance to go back and see it again, so that's about it. All right, time remaining. We can speak to him, won't we?
Are you still
all right, amazing.
Here?
You weren't a terrible sidekick. Unfortunately, one of our marks hasn't yet arrived. We'll have to go back. Great. Okay, so we get another skill. They're all slowly piling
I'm
up. All right, so this is the last... quest. This is the one I've been talking about a lot to do with the Gruul. So here we go. Well, it's time to clear up that last Char leader I told you about. His name is Virgius the Pestilent, and he is one nasty beast. See, I was just talking about warband names, and this guy doesn't even have one, which is kind of interesting. He's just got a title. But he probably has a warband, it's just that the game doesn't tell us what it is. Anyway, because a Char without warbands, I may as well go into a bit more depth here. Char without warbands are basically looked at as the scum of society. They're just spat upon, basically. They're called gladiums. But basically, these gladiums, these tend to be Char that are just complete outcasts from society. You can have Char that don't work with their warband. They can be sort of on duty for their warband, living somewhere else. And they're not necessarily viewed so badly. But yeah, generally, gladiums are spat upon. It's actually quite interesting. The leader of the Vigil, and I forget her name, but she's a Char. And she is actually a gladium herself. And she just sort of went to Lion's Arch. And she actually ended up forming or being in charge of one of the greatest, like, orders come Guild Wars 2, you know, who are working really hard to fight against the Elder Dragons, which is really quite interesting, the whole gladium thing. Anyway, so some people call it gladium, I say gladium. Anyway, I've heard he prefers the tender bones of the young for a late afternoon snack. The Char here knows something is afoot after that whole poisoning incident, so we'll need to come up with something a bit more drastic to catch their attention. Don't worry, I've taken care of that part. Just wait for me near the Hierophant stronghold and, at the right moment, rush in there and take Virgus down. You know the diversion when you see it. Believe me. Alright, okay. Diversion, shimmersion. Let's kill some Char. Alright, sweet. So let's do it. Quest added single, ugly, gruel, seek same for mindless destruction in Ascalon. Yeah, that's the longest quest name in the entire game. Would you know it? It's another one of those quests that you tend to remember the name of. I'm going to keep my heroes and henchmen with me this time just in case. Oh, and I should probably re-equip my sword. Shiro sword, which we still haven't customized, actually, I've just noticed. But yeah, and we're going to be coming down here. Now, after this quest, we should have just sort of open rain all the way around this explorable area. There's actually something quite... If you're playing along with me or you want to buff up your Eben Vanguard title really high, what people like to do sort of as a farm here is they do these two quests, right, and kill everything in the air, and you end up getting a really high multiplier on your bounty. And you can complete the Smell of Titan in the morning at the same time as well, and then sort of go back and abandon them. And generally, that's what people do for really fast Eden Vanguard points. Because there's so few explorable areas, and not necessarily quests, but things to do around here. Yeah, Eden Vanguard's actually, if you ask me, one of the harder ones, the harder titles to get. I know it was the very last one I got, just because there's so little really about, while in the other areas, you've got all these different places you can vanquish and all kinds of stuff. So yeah, this is something that a lot of people end up resorting to. Anyway, more Gruul and Elementals. Vale's waiting here. Where are we going? We're just going north a bit. All right, okay. What does our objective actually say? Ooh. Wait by the entrance of the Hierophant Stronghold for Vale to create a diversion. Wait. So I was supposed to go back up to the... Oh, crap. All right, let's go this way. At least we triggered that Resurrection Shrine, I guess. That's better than nothing, if you ask me. Yeah, I didn't think I could go over here. Here's just rock. Oh, no, you can go over. All right, okay, cool. So are we just waiting here? or up here. It would be kind of nice if quest markers actually made a mark on the map kind of thing. That would be cool. Anyway, we're at the right place. Yeah, sync quest updated. I guess we're just waiting for Vale to make his diversion now. I'm kind of scared I'll aggro those guys. Well, here we go. Vale making another diversion. He's very good at it. I just saw Anton there. I was like, oh, is that Vale again? No, of course not. Maybe I should be looking over the stronghold, actually. There he is. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. There he goes with the pheromones. Oh, God. Gruul Demogorgon champions. Jesus. Go, 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 go. Wait, where exactly am I going? Am I following them in? I'm not following him in there. He's just setting them all off to fight each other, right? Wow, we get to watch the fight from up here. Brilliant. Okay, cool. So, rush in while the Char are distracted and kill Virus the Pestilent. All right, let's go. Brilliant. So, yeah, these quests actually, yeah, I do. I really... Oh, and he actually drops the pheromones up there. That's cool. I like how the Char kind of react... the Gruul actually react to the pheromones as well. That's kind of cool. That really kind of shows how primitive they are. I was actually having a conversation with one of you from YouTube a while ago about pheromones, I think. And how... Well, kind of pheromones, like sort of instinct in people. And how sort of as we seem to be more intelligent people now, we're not so... We don't feel like we're as affected by these things so much, but yeah. I don't actually... I know that they have been scientifically proven, but I usually... If someone's like selling pheromones or something, I usually don't buy it. It's just like I don't really think they have that much sway over us. I like to think we're a bit more... We have a bit more free will than that, shall we say. Anyway, so there we go. That's him killed. See Captain Langmar for our reward. And that's actually... There are quests here to do with the people. Again, oh God, these guys, I'm really putting them on a pedestal now, aren't I? But the people we saw ages ago who ran off over here and, you know, they were going to Char territory. There are still quests here to do with them. They'll be next episode. But before we do those and see that stuff, I'd quite like to show you guys at least one particularly cool thing here in the Sacknoth Valley. So let's come down here. Because you might have been wondering why I've got Necrotic Traversal on my bar. You might not even, if you don't really play the game much, know what skill that is. This is the skill that lets you teleport to a corpse. And, I knew that would be shut. That's annoying. Oh, so I'm going to have to walk all the way around? Really? Really? Oh, hold on. Ooh, maybe I could take advantage of Necrotic Traversal. Yeah, so, this would be amazing if I can do this. Wait. Are they running around? They're trying to. Do you guys want to fight us or what? Come on, run up to the door. I think you should. Yeah, if you stand here at the door, the AI, if there's a wall that the AI can't get through, usually they'll run away. But if you stand and actually let them hit them, I think that will probably change things. Anyway, so this skill actually lets you teleport to corpses. So I just teleported to this corpse through the wall, which is really cool because basically it's kind of, you might be thinking of Assassin's Shadow Steps. Those are limited by sort of pathing. So if you couldn't have walked there, then it's not going to... Shit, I didn't mean to do that. I'm trying to get to a Resurrection Shrine, but I'm not going to make it because the archers are going to shoot me out. I'm playing without a cut. Oh, I'm getting flashbacks of prophecies now. Hold on, I'll equip my vampiric sword. I'm getting serious flashbacks of prophecies. Okay. Dodge these guys. I did do prophecies without a compass. Man, this is coming up on a year ago now, guys. I'm hoping to finish Eye of the North. I may as well just say it. I'm hoping to finish Eye of the North on the anniversary of the 1 year. So it'll be like a whole year. Oh, God. No. I don't want to be near him. I actually had my hand off the keyboard there because when I'm talking on this Let's Play, I've just been doing it more and more lately. I start moving my hands around like a teacher and it's just a bit like, why? Why am I doing that? But yeah, I'm hoping to end it all on the 1 year anniversary. Okay, hopefully they'll kill that guy and I can just rush past. Simple enough. Oh, awesome. Okay, I'm glad this worked. All right, the rest of my team should be dead. Damn, they're not all dead yet. They will be dead though. Hopefully they should be dead. Why isn't Anton dead? Anton, you need to die, man. Otherwise, I'm not going to be able to res everyone here. Unless, actually, I might be able to. Hold on. Or maybe I'll just zone through the door. Yeah, let's just zone through. Why not? Okay, so, and this actually brings us closer. Could I do it on my own? No, I can't. All right, we'll just zone out and zone back in. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, no, I'm trying to, yeah, I've drawn out too much now. But yeah, I'm hoping to end it so it's like we started the content with prophecies and we end Eye of the North a whole year down the line. I've said it many times. It was never my intent to have a whole year doing it. But I think, you know, there's quite nice... It's quite nice. And there's Vale comes to join us again. Sweet. So yeah, when we've actually completed all of his quests, we'll be able to find him permanently as a collector soon, which I will demonstrate to you guys in a second. But Let's continue on. Obviously, I will be ending Eye of the North after a year, but I do want to continue doing Warring Kryta and all that kinds of stuff. I think there's a big difference between Eye of the North and Warring Kryta, though, in that the Guild Wars Beyond stuff is kind of... it's just going back to areas we've already seen. There's a lot less new content. It's more just new quests. So that's quite different. Anyway, right. So what have we got here? Well, we've got this big rock here, okay? Now, at the top of this rock... As we will hopefully soon see... Actually, I'm going to turn on my compass, just because... will the compass even help? I doubt it will, really, that much. No, because they don't appear on the compass, do they? I think it's up there. Basically, on top of this rock... I think it... Yeah, it's got to be up there. It is up there. Right, hold on. I'll send my guys off to kill these while I'm... Well, they're doing amazing, aren't they? Shit. Ugh, guys, I'm trying to change my controls here. You're not supposed to be dying constantly. It's only a couple of char, Jesus. Right, so what I want to do is actually rebind a key that I haven't been playing with since we started Canther, which is... Where's the targeting section? Down here, here we go. So, targeting... Show targets, here we go. Right, oh, I've actually got it assigned to something. No, we're going to go left, alt, and show others left control, which is what it usually should be. All right, so by doing this, can you see this up here? You can see his name up there. That is a raven, guys. That's a raven. The only place in the entire game where you, as a ranger, can get this pet, the raven, is by looking on top of this huge mountain. It's really rare. This is the only place in the entire game where you can find ravens. And I think it's amazing that Arenanet actually added something like this in. There's so many of their sort of Arenanet's philosophies are built around, oh, you shouldn't limit people to do this, you shouldn't have stuff, you know. And I think that actually kind of, you can take philosophies like that too far with games where in the end everything's just a bit kind of lame, where everyone gets everything and there's not much sort of distinction between things. And, you know, that most of the time through Guild Wars, pets have kind of followed the same story, in that none of them have really been that interesting. Most of the time Arenanet have just said, oh my god, where is everyone? Where is everyone, guys? Oh crap, I know, it's because I unbound my key. There we go, unflag them. Oh, this has been such a massive fail. Anyway, yeah, so most of the pets in the game sort of have just been, oh, they wander around here, and there's never really been anything that special about them. But this is, in my opinion, the raven, the rare... Where are you guys going? There we go, they're coming now. The raven is, in my opinion, the rarest, most awesome pet in the game. Just because the phoenix, you know, you can only get that at one place at the end of... factions. Indeed, there's another type of phoenix which is kind of like the raven, I guess, in its rarity. Look, Menlo just got like 3 shot. Oh, this is so bad. They're just some char, my god, and some gruel. Actually, there are, I guess, a fair few things here, but so yeah, I mean, this is just really cool. I just like what they did with the raven here. I'm not going to drag out this stupid little speech too much longer. But there's something cool that you can do here. Obviously, I'm not a ranger. I'm not going to give Peter a raven. I was kind of tempted to give him a raven because, you know, I've been forgetting Charlie so much recently. I was thinking maybe just sort of get him a raven, but, you know, I wouldn't want to replace Charlie or anything. So, but what you got to do to actually get your hands on one of these things is you've got to wait for it to come near the edge, and then you've got to actually attack it and or try and use comfort animal. What I'm going to do is, why wasn't it recharged? If it was recharged, I could have charmed it right there and then. So what we're going to have to do here is wait for the raven to come right up to the edge. This is why it's so rare, because it's just like right on the edge of there, and you're never going to see it unless you see the nameplate. And you're never going to really be able to get up there. It's just really, really good, really well hidden. And it's a unique model and everything. Obviously, we have seen them before. The first video of this Let's Play was... the Flight North, Gwen's story, and there were ravens there, and I mentioned that there were rare pets. Well, this is the only way you can actually get them, because obviously in Gwen's story you can't have Charm Animal with you, so yeah, it is very cool. And now the raven's completely disappeared. This may have to call for a cut here where I cut until we actually manage to get our hands on the bloody thing. Oh, here's one. Is he close enough? Is he in cast range? There we go. So I've summoned an assassin up there. My friends have killed it, and now I've just used necrotic traversal to teleport to its corpse. So that's the raven. It's dead. I know, it's a shame. There should be some more up here. Now that we're actually up here, we'll be able to have a good look. But because of necrotic traversal, we can actually teleport up here. There should be no real way to walk up here. Now, if I'm correct, this is the place where the cutscene that we saw at the start of the... what was it called again? I always forget what this mission's called. It wasn't Warband of Brothers, was it? Yeah, it was. Well, at the start of Assault on the Stronghold, I think this is where they took place of it. You get an incredible view of the front of the stronghold. don't you? And you get to have a right good look around up here in a place where I'm pretty sure Arenanet never really considered anybody would come up here. There usually are multiple ravens around here. Usually, but I guess only one spawned this time. I usually see at least two. But yeah, so this is kind of just a nice little place. One of the first times I ever really got into taking screenshots on Guild Wars, it was up here. I was just taking all these images of all the views and stuff and how you could see on top of all the other rocks around here. And there are some weird places you can walk to, like you can walk through this thing and sort of... But yeah, it's just quite cool. I wanted to show you guys this sort of as a by-the-by as we left Sacknell Valley. I guess it didn't really end up like that, considering how how long it actually took me to get here. But yeah, it's just very, very odd around here, right, as you can see. So, can we actually keep going up? Can we go up there? No, I think this is probably the height you can get to. But yeah, so there you go. That's the ravens. That's how you find them in Sacknell Valley. There are a few other cool things in Sacknell Valley. Let's see where Vale is. Let's cash in this reward with Langmar and finish this level, this video. It's just the raven is a cool pet. To be honest, I only think it's so cool because it's quite rare and so out of the way, and it's not the kind of thing that people would really search for and think was particularly rare in the first place. So whenever you get a raven, it's kind of like, yeah, this is really cool. And people are just like, oh, where did you find it? Because this was one of the pets I wish I'd got it the first time through on Eye of the North, but it was actually like a year before I realized it even existed there, if I'm perfectly honest. Anyway, here's Captain Langmar.
Who goes there?
She says, haha, what great fun. Remind me to ask Vale where he got all those gruel pheromones. On a second thought, I don't want to know. Alright, okay, there we go. So that's all of Vale's quest complete. If we rezone, I'm pretty sure you have to rezone here. Just to cap off the video, and then go back out. We can now see by coming up here, this path here, by the way. Oh no, there is Vale. Alright, never mind. Well, here's Vale, and now he actually spawns here as a collector. So that's all the stuff you have to do to get him to spawn here as a collector. It is a bit of a pain in the ass, I'll give you guys that. But when you finally do, you can speak to him.
What news?
And he says, you have earned my respect, friend, in more ways than one. While we may never be able to grow old and stitch quilts together, I will try to stick to jobs that do not put me on the other side of the battlefront as you. But I offer more than mere friendship. This is a mask of the Mo Zing. These masks are wielded only by travellers that call no man or woman their master, and I know that to be true of you. Alas, all things come with a price, even between friends. A trifling thing, really. Bring me 250 superb char carvings in exchange for my masks. Trust me, it's worth it. So this is kind of the reason why people used to grind on these things. It's a really prestigious thing, and you know, you often get a lot of assassins wearing it, and yeah, it's kind of one of those typical things. It's just basically a ninja mask. I will hopefully show it to you guys at some point in the Let's Play. But it's a cool item anyway, I like it. And the Mo Zing is actually established lore before this mask appeared. Zemnai, if you remember when we met her, added in Nightfall, she was a Mo Zing. So yeah, it's pretty cool. I guess Vale's a Mo Zing as well. And if you want, you can be one too. I've actually got a really cool outfit I like to wear on my Mesmer where he's got a Mo Zing, which is pretty cool. But yeah, that's by the by. That is Vale, guys. That's all of Vale's quests. That's the end of Vale's stuff. We might see him again as I pick up the mask, if that actually happens, or I might just get off camera. I don't know. I do know that off camera I need to rebind all my keys now and my compass and everything, because that was all a bit messy, and sell that stuff in my inventory. So yeah, I guess that's what's on my job list at the moment. And as for you guys, I guess I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope this loading screen comes off. There we go. And I will see you. Come on, load. I hate the way Guild Wars does this. It takes so long to load your model. Do you guys get this a lot? Like, but you can see your breath. It's crazy. All right, there we go. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Take care, and I will see you next time. See you next time, guys.